shot, one opportunity to seize everything you ever wanted. One moment that you captured, just let it slip. Yo. His palms are sweaty, knees weak, arms are heavy. There's vomit on his sweater already. Mom's spaghetti, he's nervous, but on the surface he looks calm and ready to...
Maros, Mari, Money, Massive, big, 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 big. Happy 21st birthday to you, man. Hope the boys and all your family have treated you well on your birthday. You deserve it, for sure. It feels like I've known you all my life. Like, I can't really remember when I haven't been mates with you, really. It did start in that year 7, senior 7 class. It was one hell of a class. When you walked in late and there was nowhere else to sit but next to me, so I was like, yeah, come sit next to me, man. And it all began from there. Our friendship blossomed from there. Man, the amount of memories I've had with you, especially at school. One of the main ones is, get it out of the way first, that fight with Hanson. I'm going to have to set the record straight here. You didn't throw a punch at him, man. You ripped one of his buttons off. Yeah, you gave him a few jumper punches, but if it wasn't for me and Adam and Steven, I think you'd probably look like a different sort of Muddy. But man, you are one shit talker, and that's what makes you so funny. Like, you talk the most shit out of anyone I know. I think that you are the most shit talker that anyone knows. That's why you suit cricket so much. Another good memory was when Big Rob Dog got stuck in the fence. I just remember us all boys watching him there. He's got caught in the fence and us just pissing ourselves. School footy was an absolute laugh with you in the team. Pissing off Mr. Ferrara and shit like that. One of the most funniest things I reckon was in our year 12. It was our health exam, it was our last exam. And you were talking to Dwayne about Sons of Anarchy or some shit like that. And Mr. Brusco was just like, yeah, you know, come on, Brody, just like pot down a little bit. And you turn around and you're like, why don't you shut the fuck up? his face was just like, what the fuck? Oh, man, you're just like, I don't give a fuck. I'm getting out of here after this exam. Fuck you, Nazareth. Oh, walking out with just the... You made that. That was your little symbol with that. And and you were one of the only people to keep saying Kent from year 9 days. Everyone stopped saying it. You were the one that just stuck with it. I think you eventually brought it back. As the years have gone on, your public speaking's become pretty good. I don't know where it's come from, but you make the best speeches going around.
All right, boys, I just want to say a couple of words before we do it.
Thank you all for joining us.
Yeah, no, you're all right.
We might have only got up here
10 hours ago, but you know what? Fuck, it's
going to
be a good Queen's birthday, even if we can't do it one day, right? We came here as fucking soldiers and we're leaving as an army.
That's just some of your best work there. You've definitely done a few speeches and they're nothing short of absolute quality. I've probably known you in two different stages. I've known you as the Brody Snow and then I've known you as the Muddy. It was in Echuca with all the fellas. That was an absolute rip of a trip. And you jumped in the Murray and then you just come out with with a mo full of mud, and that's when Muddy was born, and the sky was the limit for you. Then you just Muddy rose to the top, and I love the name. Everyone loves the name. Everyone gets around it. I love it. I don't think many people know your first name, to be honest. You probably prefer being called Muddy over Brody anyway. Change it on your birth certificate, you probably would in the future. Call your kids Muddy Junior or something. Muddy and Rockos. One thing you keep amazing me by, in high school you were one of the funniest kids going around, and then every year you somehow got funnier and funnier. Like, I didn't think someone could get even funnier as the years go on. I thought you'd reached your limit, but you keep getting funnier and funnier. Like, just keep doing what you're doing, and I love it. And everyone else loves it as well. That's why you're so loved by everyone in the group and all the other fellas as well. I know the VBs will be definitely flowing, and I wish I could have had one with you, but this is probably the best I could have done. I was never going to miss out on having one with you, so got the old Victor Bravo right here, the best I could have come up with here, so let's have one together, Muddy. Happy birthday, bro. Hope it's a good one.
Yeah, this album is dedicated to all the teachers that told me I never amount to nothing. To all the people that lived above the buildings that I was hustling from that called the police on me when I was just trying to make some money to feed my daughter. And to all my peoples in the struggle, you know what I'm saying? It's all good, baby, baby. It was all a dream. I used to read Word Up magazine. Salt and pepper and Heavy D up in the limousine. Hanging pictures on my wall.
What's up? This is our Mados, reporting from the Welcome back, ladies and gents. I like to welcome you to the talk.
That hip hop would take it this far. Now I'm in the limelight cause I rhyme tight. Time to get paid, blow up like the World Trade. Born sinner, the opposite of a winner. Remember when I used to eat sardines for dinner? Easter Raw G, Brucey B, Kid Capri, Funk Master Flex, Love Bug, Star Ski. I'm blowing up like you thought I would. Call a crib, same number, same hood. It's all good. And if you don't know, now you know. I made the change from a common thief to up close and personal with Robin Leach. And I'm far from cheap. I smoke skunk with my peeps all day. Spread love, it's the Brooklyn way. The Moet and Alizé keep me pissed.